crisp air, colorful leaves, spicy candles, and cozy coffee drinks. Hey guys, I'm here today to inspire you for fall with this makeup look. To me, this is sort of the epitome of like tiptoeing into those fall looks. I wanted to do something that's maybe a little different than your average like warm, sort of like pumpkin spice vibe. I just think that this is a great way to sort of like get into fall in a little bit of a different way. Now, if you're new here to my channel, my name is Kelly and I am a professional hair and makeup artist. And here on YouTube, I strive to keep beauty real, real honest, real relatable, and real fun. So if that sounds like something you'd enjoy, don't forget to subscribe. But right now we're gonna jump into this fall look and get ready for the season. All right, let's start with primer. Now I haven't used this, but I'm very excited because I think it'll be really perfect for this time of year. This is the Ulla Henriksen Banana Bright Face Primer. This has vitamin C and banana powder inspired pigments. So this is really gonna help, or it says it's going to help brighten the skin, give you like that lighter, brighter appearance. And I think this is gonna be perfect because I feel like once fall and winter comes, our skin starts looking a little sallow. We sort of need that little bit of boost. Now it does say on here that it can be worn alone, under makeup, or dabbed on top of makeup as a highlight. That's really interesting. I don't know that I'll be brave enough to try that today, but let's go ahead and put some of this on. I have to be honest, I totally Googled to see how you pronounce this brand before I started this video because I feel like this is one of those brands that gets pronounced like totally 17 different ways. So I went here on YouTube and I searched and I saw a video of Ulle actually talking about his brand. So he pronounced his own name. So I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing it right and I hope I'm doing it justice. Oh no, you guys. Oh no. No. Let's see. I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to see this. I'm getting a bunch of pilling. Shoot. Oh man. Well, so I can tell you one thing. It's really glowy. I can see it on my hands. I was actually gonna say, oh my gosh, this is so pretty, but it's really peeling and pilling. Now, I do have one product on my skin and that is the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Serum. So it could just be that these two don't work well together. So I guess we're gonna have to come back to this primer at another time. That's so sad. Okay, well, so much for that product. I'm gonna try to wipe this off and I'll try to use that primer in another video where I haven't used the Charlotte Tilbury. I'll keep you guys updated on how that goes. Okay, so hopefully I got most of that off. Let me know in the comments if you have tried either the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Serum or the Banana Bright Primer, if you've had pilling with either one of those. Now, I'm doing this video at least a week before it's gonna go up, so I'll take some time to use the primer on its own and I'll just update you guys down in the comments on how it went with other products, but that's such a bummer. Okay, backup plan, just going in with my very beloved Hello Fab Coconut Skin Smoothie Priming Moisturizer from First Aid Beauty. Now, I think that this is probably a little bit more hydrating than the Banana Bright. I don't think it has quite the like warm glow that that other one did, but this will definitely get us through. All right, I think I'm actually gonna do my eyes first today, which I don't normally do, but because I am going to be using this palette and I haven't used it before, I just wanna see how it is as far as fallout. And then also because we'll probably do something a little smokier, that way I can like brighten up if need be. So I am so excited to use this. You guys have no idea how long I've wanted this. I will definitely blame Mandy Lee here on YouTube for this one because I know she has a big place in her heart for Juvia's Shadows just like I do. And she's always talked about this one. And I saw that recently she ranked all of her Juvia's Place shadows and she put this one, I think at the top. If not at the top, it was really close to the top. I can't remember, but I will link that video down below if you guys wanna check that one out. All right, so I just went through with a little bit of the ColourPop No Filter Concealer. This is the shade Light 18, and then dusted a little bit of the Becca Hydra Mist powder on my eyelid just so I could have a little bit of coverage there. Again, if you guys have been watching me, you know I really like to have a little coverage on my lid just because they are a little bit veiny before we get into the shadows. By the way, I'm not sure if I actually mentioned which palette this is. This is the Nomad from Juvia's Place. I recently did an order. I saw that it was actually on sale, I think on Ulta. So then I looked at the Juvia's Place website and this was, if not the same price, maybe a little cheaper, but then they were having these bundle deals that I was really interested in, so I ended up getting like 5 other palettes. So you might want to stick around through this video because maybe there's a little giveaway. So now we're going to crack into this. I think that these colors are so beautiful. I really think that to me, this is like totally fall. You have this beautiful camel color, a nice little like dusty mustard. Of course, this like olive green is just speaking to me. And then you have some nice smoky shades. Oh, you guys, this is such a beautiful shade. Wow, that is super pretty. Reminds me a little bit of, is it Firebutts from the Sydney Grace and Mel Thompson? But maybe just like a little darker and more olivey. Yeah, that's what I would say. So I think this is going to be a fun one to use. What I'll do is while I'm working through this, I'll just speed through it, but I'll pop a picture of this guy up so you guys can see what I'm using as we go through. Okay, so my curiosity got the better of me, so I went and grabbed Tiny Marvel so I could compare it to this middle shade here. I was totally off. Like, compared to Firebutts, this one almost looks gold. So this is that middle shade from the Juvia's Place palette, and this is Firebutts, so I don't know what I was thinking. Okay, I am really, really digging this palette so far. I love it. I will say I do have a good, respectable amount of fallout on my face, and that could be partially because I knew I was going to be going in with my face makeup afterwards, so I just kind of like went in there like a Neanderthal, but I'm not really surprised. I mean, when you're working with a little bit like softer metallics like this, because it does look like it's mostly coming from this darker metallic, that's gonna happen. That's exactly why I decided to do my face makeup last. But now I'm kind of struggling on how I wanna finish this off because part of me just wants to go in and like do really smoky under the eye, but the other part of me wants to like draw in these warmer shades to kind of like give it a little pop. So I can't decide yet. So since I can't decide, I think what I need to do is just go through with the face makeup and then I can kind of like feel out the vibe and go from there. Coffee break. By the way, in case you're wondering what I'm drinking, it is the Caribou Mahogany Coffee, and then I add the chocolate cherry collagen latte from Vital Proteins. Super yummy. And I'm all about the warm drinks as we get into fall. It just kind of gives me that like cozy feeling. All right, for our foundation today, I'm gonna be using one that I feel like, for me, sort of like dipped under the radar as far as talking about it on my channel here, and it's the Bite Changemaker Supercharged Micellar Foundation. Now, I was really excited to try this because both Alana Davidson and Samantha Ravendahl said that they loved this, and I feel like I have similar like skin preferences as they do. This is at the like top end of the coverage that I would prefer, but even though it does have a little bit more coverage than I usually wear, it looks so natural and beautiful. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw this on for you guys and you can see what you think. Okay, before I go ahead and pop on some of that ColourPop concealer, I just wanted you guys to see the skin. This is so beautiful. Like, I mean, it almost is like so flawless that I feel like I have too much on, if that makes sense. But I don't. It's just for me, it is a higher coverage than I am normally used to wearing, but it looks so, so beautiful, so skin-like, because it has, I would say, a satin finish to it, and it gives you that little bit of a glow. Like, I mean, you guys can see even like on my cheeks here. Now, obviously I put on that coconut smoothie primer and that does have a little bit of luminosity to it, but not that much. And so most of this lovely glow is coming from this foundation. And I think if you have, I would say, a normal to dry skin type, this is probably gonna be lovely on you. If you have an oilier skin type, If you have a more oily skin type, I would say that this would be a perfect foundation if you're going for that dewy look. But if a normal like dewy foundation just makes you slip and slide all over, I think this would be a good one, because I think that it just has that lovely finish, and with a little bit of powder, it's gonna last on you all day long. So I love this. I'm gonna throw on some concealer and we will keep going. Because this is so much more coverage than I would normally wear, I really just put a little bit of that concealer right under the eye and then a little bit down my nose, just where I get my redness. So I'm just gonna go through with that Becca powder again and just lightly set this right under the eye. And then just on my nose and T-zone. And like right in here, because I get a little oily. Maybe on the chin too, why not? And honestly, you guys, I actually, when I open this up, I usually just take what is right on this cap, and because I don't want as much as what's inside. You guys know I love the Hourglass Veil Powder. I do feel like this Becca one is a little bit heavier, so I just try to use even less, which is like almost nothing because I really don't use much of the Veil Powder. So I just try to take like the tiniest bit of this powder, but it will help set this under eye and keep it in place all day. Now for bronzer, I'm just gonna go through with the Marc Jacobs Omega Bronze. This is the Tantastic shade. I really like this one as we kind of head into the cooler months, just because it has a much more like neutral, almost leaning cool shade. And I'm really just gonna use this to like add a little definition to the face. So almost contour more than bronze. Alright, now for blush, I'm gonna go through with the Patrick Ta Double Take Cream and Powder Blush. This is the shade Do We Know Her. I got this in my last Sephora haul. While I think a lot of people might not sort of think of these colors as fall colors, I think that when you're doing such a deep eye like this, and I know I'm gonna go through with a nude lip, like a deeper nude, I think that a little brightness to the face can be very flattering. So I'm just gonna use these two. Of course, we're gonna go through with the powder first and then the cream, which over coverage like this, I haven't done yet. I have worn this over like a tinted moisturizer and that has been okay. So we're gonna see how this goes. I'm just like putting my trust in the process. Yeah, I really like that. What do you guys think about that little bit of like a brighter color with a darker look? So now for highlight, we're gonna go through with an oldie but a goodie. This is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in Champagne Pop. This is one that I love pulling out this time of year because it has that warmth, but it's not so gold as our skin starts to get a little bit lighter in the wintertime. I find that like really gold highlights, they just look odd on my skin. So this way it's just a little bit softer. I'm gonna go through with a nice duo fiber brush just so that it doesn't get too blingy. And then since that Juvia's Place palette doesn't have a light highlight shade, I'm gonna go through with this just on my inner corner and brow bone to highlight. Okay, now that I've got the rest of the face done, I think I'm gonna stay with the like deep, dark, smoky vibe. So I am just gonna stick more in these darker tones on this side of the palette for this eye look. I will go ahead and throw up swatches on my Instagram so that you guys can see this. And let me know down in the comments if you guys would like to see another look with this. Like to me, I could see this around like Halloween or like Thanksgiving time. Like this is sort of like fall harvest vibes to me, totally. Alright guys, all we have left is lippy and we are in full-on fall mode. Now, like I said, I just went through, filled in my brows, and then for mascara, I was really like teetering between the Thrive Liquid Lash and then the Hourglass Unlocked. I did go through with the Liquid Lash. Now, if you guys would kind of like to know my thoughts on those versus each other, I did put that in a recent review roundup, so I'll pop it up here for you guys. So now we just have lips. Now, I must have been in a mood because I pulled out two lip colors that I think are actually kind of similar to each other, so I sort of have a little bit of a dupe. It's not exact, but I pulled out the ColourPop Lippy Stick in Aquarius, and then I also got out Very Victoria from Charlotte Tilbury. Now I want to put these side by side so we can look at them together because I was actually surprised by myself in thinking like, like these are kind of similar-ish, maybe not as similar as I'm thinking now that I'm like pulling these out next to each other. Oh no, they are actually kind of similar. Okay, so right here we have Very Victoria and then Aquarius is just under it. So Aquarius is obviously more sheeny, but surprisingly it also has more of a cooler undertone. I know a lot of people when it comes to fall lipsticks, they think like really deep, vampy, maybe warm tones, but I don't go towards those that much. If I'm gonna do like a deeper color, it's normally like a more bold tone, if that makes sense. So like a poppy raspberry or something like that, just because I find that like the darker the lip color, the older I look. It's just sort of how I feel. So I can't decide which one to do. Okay, I think we're gonna do Very Victoria. I only hesitate a little bit because Very Victoria is a little bit more matte. I would prefer the sheen of the Aquarius shade, but I like the color of Very Victoria better, so we'll go through with that one. I did go through with the Charlotte Tilbury Super Size Me liner as well. If you guys saw, I picked that one up at the recent Sephora sale, and I just like that because it very much matches my lip color. So I just wanted something that doesn't necessarily look lined, it just looks like my lip is defined, if that makes sense. Yeah, I think that this has like fall vibes, don't you? Like, and this for me is about as matte as I would go on my lips. So to me, this is a matte lip. Yes, I'm all about this look. This really gives me fall vibes, and fall is like my favorite time of year. I am just so excited for the season. Speaking of being excited, let's talk about that giveaway I mentioned earlier. So first of all, I just recently, like I think it was maybe a couple, last week. Of course, by the time you guys see this video, it'll have been a while ago, but I tipped over 300 subscribers, which obviously is like so minute compared to a lot of beauty channels out there, a lot of channels in general. But for me, it was very exciting, and more so, it was really more about the interaction that I've seen on my channel recently. And that just really warms my heart because like I've said in previous videos, really the reason I started this channel was to start conversation and really enjoy talking to you about makeup and all of the things that we love or aren't loving so much. So I just want to say thank you guys so much for being a part of this channel and, you know, being part of the conversation. I love that. So I do have a couple giveaways actually that I'm going to be doing, one here on my channel and then one on Instagram. So the one that we're going to be doing here is for the Warrior palette from Juvia's Place. Now what I'm going to do is post pictures of the inside of this palette up here for you guys so that I don't have to open this box. I do not have this palette. I don't doubt that it's gonna be amazing. When I was on the site, like I said, trying to get that Nomad palette, I saw that they had the Warrior bundle and I really wanted to do something for you guys. I thought that this one would also be a great palette for fall because it is such a warm, like goldy neutral palette. So this is gonna be a beautiful one if you enjoy those shades. Now let's talk about the rules of this giveaway. It's pretty simple. You need to be subscribed here to my channel and you need to leave a comment down below letting me know what your fall favorite is. It could be a candle, it could be a lipstick, whatever it is that makes you really think of fall. You will have a week from the day that this video goes live to enter. This is also a US only giveaway, but if you are international and you'd like a chance to win, I will be offering my Instagram giveaway to anyone internationally as well. Now, if you'd like details on that, please go follow me at Keep Beauty Real. I will have a post going up today as well on that giveaway. So again, thank you guys so much for being a part of my channel here. I can't wait to see what the future holds for us here. Thanks so much for hanging out with me to play with some makeup today. I hope this got you inspired for fall. If it did, go ahead and give this a thumbs up. I hope to see you here on my channel in the future. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you really soon.